There should have been 155 ambulances on the roads of London today. 32 stayed in the depot, and non-emergency hospital appointments were again badly hit. The struggle to maintain the emergency service has been helped by the below-average number of 999 calls, but the strain is beginning to show. And if the officers who run the service and the control assistants who answer the calls decide to join the crews in their overtime ban, breaking point could be reached, according to the officers' chief negotiator.
The effect would be very serious and would take place very quickly. And the very fact that an overtime ban could have such a major effect on the service proves that the levels of overtime worked are quite disgraceful for an emergency service.
Right now, the officers and control assistants are being balloted on whether or not to join their colleagues in the overtime ban. But already officers at three London stations, Bromley, Isleworth and Greenwich, have jumped the gun. It's said to be an indication of the solidarity between officers and their crews.
It's very strong at the moment. Officers and crews work very closely together in providing this key emergency service, and so they feel very strongly in support of the pay claim, which is common to both groups.
How do you think the officers will vote in this ballot?
It's difficult to say. The result will be known on the 29th, but from the indications we've had so far, it seems as if our members are heeding the call and will vote to back the negotiators in the overtime ban.
Almost 10 years ago, the armed forces' deployment of the so-called Green Goddesses during the firemen's dispute showed the government's determination to control the public services. The possibility of using army ambulances in the current dispute is moving closer. The Ministry of Defence said today they'd consider any request from another government department. Hey Gordon for Thames News.